So welcome my students. In the paper of virology, today we are proceeding for discussing the structural properties of the viruses. In my previous lecture, we have discussed the general properties of the viruses, and today we are proceeding for the structural properties. Now the question is, what are structural properties? The structural properties of viruses means the properties which are related to the structural components of the viruses. Now you know viruses, they are mainly consisting of three structural components. One, that is the nucleic acid, which is present at the center, and that nucleic acid, it is surrounded by a proteinaceous coat that is called as a capsid, and in some viruses that capsid in turn is surrounded by a membrane that is called as a envelope. Among these three components, the important structural component is the capsid, and this capsid can be called as the shape determining component of the viruses, and today we are discussing about that capsid component of the viruses. So just as I told you, each of the virus particle is consisting of a central nucleic acid core, and that central nucleic acid core in turn is surrounded by a protein coat, and that is actually called as the capsid. So it is proteinaceous component surrounding to the genetic material of the viruses, that is nothing but the capsid. Now this capsid, it is made up of the subunits of the proteins, and those subunits of the proteins, they are called as the capsomeres. Now the arrangement of these capsomeres within the structure of the capsid is specific, and that specific arrangement is responsible for giving three different shapes to the viruses. And those three different shapes of the viruses are the spherical, helical, and the complex, or spherical, rod-shaped, and the complex structure or complex shape of the viruses. Now, you can see in this picture, these are the three representative viruses which are representing the spherical viruses or rod-shaped viruses and the complex viruses. Among these three one, the first one is the, this is the, among these three, the first one is the structure of human immunodeficiency virus, that is HIV virus, and this is an example of the spherical virus. Now the second virus is an example of the rod shaped virus, and its name is tobacco mosaic virus, and third virus is an example of a complex virus, and it is one of the bacteriophage. Specifically, it is a T4 bacteriophage. So the shape of the viruses, it is totally dependent on the structure or shape of the capsid, and within this capsid, the capsomere subunits are there, and those capsomere subunits, they are arranged in a specific manner because of which the viruses, they are getting three different shapes. So here in spherical viruses, the arrangement of the capsomeres is in such a way that the capsid becomes spherical. Or in rod shaped viruses, the arrangement of capsomeres is in a specific manner around the single stranded RNA molecules, because of which viruses, they are getting rod shaped. That means their width is becoming less and their length is becoming more. And in the third type of the viruses, that means in the complex viruses, the spherical or rod shape is not there, but the structurally viruses, they are complex. They may contain the head region, which is little bit icosahedral, and the tail region, which is little bit rod shaped, and therefore the structure can be called as the complex structure. Now among the three types of the capsids, the first important type of the capsid, it is called as the polyhedral capsids. And polyhedral capsids, they are having the spherical symmetry. That means polyhedral capsids are responsible for giving the spherical shape to the viruses. Just as I told you, the most common example of it is the HIV virus. So in HIV virus, the capsid is polyhedral, because of which the virus is getting the spherical shape. Now polyhedral capsids, or the capsids with spherical symmetry, are isometric because they have the linear dimensions. And actually these are regular solid geometrical figures forming polyhedral structures. Now you can see, this is the figure of the capsid with spherical symmetry और इट इज ए पॉलीहेड्रल कैप्सिड. सो इट इज ए पॉलीहेड्रल और इकोसाहेड्रल ज्योमेट्रिक शेप. द न्यूक्लिक एसिड इज पैक्ड इन ए स्पेसिफिक मैनर विद इन दीज हॉलो पॉलीहेड्रल हेड्स और पॉलीहेड्रल कैप्सिड्स. द मोस्ट कॉमनली ऑकरिंग स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ द स्फेरिकल सिमेट्री और पॉलीहेड्रल कैप्सिड इज द इकोसाहेड्रॉन, एंड दैट इकोसाहेड्रॉन इज कंसिस्टिंग ऑफ 12 कॉर्नर्स, 20 ट्राइंगुलर फेसेस एंड 30 एजेस. सो इन दिस फिगर यू कैन से देर आर 12 कॉर्नर्स एंड 20 ट्राइंगुलर फेसेस एंड 30 एजेस, बिकॉज ऑफ विच द कैप्सिड इज इकोसाहेड्रल, एंड दिस इज द मोस्ट कॉमन स्ट्रक्चर ऑकरिंग इन द मोस्ट ऑफ द वायरसेस. सो दिस इज द एग्जाम्पल ऑफ द वायरस विथ द पॉलीहेड्रल कैप्सिड और द स्फेरिकल सिमेट्री. Within this capsid, there is presence of two types of the capsomeres, and those two types are described as the pentamers and hexamers. The pentamers are the subunits which are consisting of five monomers, and these pentamers are generally situated at the corners of the capsid. And the hexamers are consisting of six monomers, and these hexamers are responsible for the formation of the triangular faces. Now in this picture you can see this is the structure of the pentamer, which is consisting of the five subunits, and this is the structure of the hexamer, which is consisting of the six subunits. Now the pentamers are responsible for the formation of the corners. So these are present at the corners, and the hexamers are responsible for the formation of the triangular faces. Now such polyhedral capsids, they can be either naked or they can be enveloped. Now the examples of naked polyhedral capsids are the poliovirus, adenovirus and papillomavirus. And the examples of polyhedral enveloped viruses are herpes simplex virus as well as the HIV virus. That means in the polyhedral enveloped viruses, the capsid is surrounded by additional membrane, that is the envelope. But in the naked polyhedral capsids, the capsid is not surrounded by any kind of the membrane. That is the difference between naked viruses and the enveloped viruses. Now the second type of the capsid, that is called as the helical capsid, and helical capsid is having the helical symmetry. Now in such capsids, the monomers are arranged in a helix around a single rotational axis. The most common example of helical capsids is the capsid that is present in one important virus, that is the tobacco mosaic virus, that is responsible for causing tobacco mosaic disease in the tobacco plants. We can see this is the figure of the tobacco mosaic virus. Here the subunits of the capsid are arranged in the helical manner, because of which the virus is getting the rod shape. That means the width of the virus is comparatively less. It is just 18 nanometer, but the length of the virus is comparatively more, and it is about 30 nanometer. And the central core region, it is having diameter of just 2 nanometer. The helical capsids may be again naked, or they also may be surrounded by an envelope. The example of naked helical capsid is tobacco mosaic virus, and the example of enveloped helical capsid is the influenza virus. The most extensively studied helical capsid is again of the tobacco mosaic virus. Now you can see this figure also. It is the figure of tobacco mosaic virus, where the subunits of the capsids are arranged in the helical manner around a coil of the single stranded RNA, and because of which the virus is getting the rod shaped. That means its width or diameter is less than its length. Now third type of the capsid, it is the complex, or third types of the viruses are the viruses with the complex structure or complex symmetry. Some viruses, they do not fall either in the polyhedral symmetry or in helical symmetry. That means they are neither helical or spherical, but their structure is complex one. And the examples of such viruses are pox virus, vaccinia virus, and many bacteriophages. Now you see, this is the structure of the pox virus. Now another structure is of the vaccinia virus. Now both these are the examples of the complex viruses. They have complex internal structure with ovoid to brick shaped exterior. That means they are neither spherical nor rod shaped, and structurally they are complex one. You are getting here idea about the complexity of their structures. Another important group of the complex viruses is large bacteriophages. And the most common representative of the bacteriophages is the coliphages. Now, coliphages again are of two types, that is T odd phages and T even phages. Now, this is the structure of one of the T even phage, and that is the T4 bacteriophage. Now, its head is resembling like that of the icosahedron, and there is presence of a tail region which is like that of the helical capsid. And it is a combination of the icosahedral head and little bit helical tail, and therefore the virus, it can be called as a complex virus. Now within this head region, just as I told you, there is presence of an icosahedron, and inside of this icosahedral head there is presence of the genetic material of that virus, that is the DNA. The tail is consisting of the collar, which is used for attachment to the head region, and this collar, it is again a proteinic component. And below this collar, the remaining part of the tail is there, and tail is actually consisting of a central tube, and that central tube is surrounded by a contractile sheath. At the lower side of this contractile sheath, there is presence of an hexagonal base plate, and at the lower side of this hexagonal base plate, there is presence of the pin-like structures. In addition to that, from the corners of this hexagonal base plate, there is origin of the tail fibers, and these tail fibers, they are useful for the attachment or adsorption of the phage particles to the receptor sites that are present on the host cell surfaces. There is considerable variation in the structure of these bacteriophages. Now, many coliphages, they have two icosahedral heads, and the phages, specifically coliphages like T1 and T5 coliphages and lambda phages, they have sheathless tail, and that tail is lacking the base plate, and it is terminating in a rudimentary tail fibers. Now you can see, this is the figure of T5 bacteriophage. It is one of the example of the T odd phage, and in this phage there is presence of an icosahedral head, but in the tail region just there is presence of a tail tube, but it is not been surrounded by a sheath. And at the lower side, there is no presence of the base plate, but the tail, it is terminating in a rudimentary tail fibers, with the help of which the virus is attaching to its host cell surface. The coliphages like T3 and T7, they have short and non-contractile tail, and also they don't have the tail fibers. You can see, this is the image of the T7 coliphage. It is having icosahedral head within which there is presence of the genetic material, but here the tail is very short, and that is non-contractile and without tail fibers. So such viruses, they complete their reproductive cycle using a variety of the tail structures. The complex bacterial viruses with both head and tails are said to be the viruses with binal symmetry. Because they possess both, that is, icosahedral head and helical tail. That is, combination of icosahedral head and helical tail, and because of which the structure of the virus is becoming complex one. So this is about the properties of one of the structural component of the viruses, and that is the capsids. Thank you for kind listening.